Welcome to the inaugural episode of Hella Trades. I'm Ralphie D, along with my co-host, JB. In this show, we will dissect the trade paperbacks, graphic novels, and comic book stories that we grew up loving.
Or hating.
At times, one of us hasn't even read the story the other co-host suggested, like today's story.
Today, I suggested that Ralph read Daredevil Born Again.
Yes. This was my first time with this one, and I gotta admit, it was a great ride.
A classic by Frank Miller and Dave Mazzucchelli.
Yes. And I tell you what, man, the themes in this story were adult. Very adult. But let's get into the plot.
Spoiler alert, if you have not read this, we will be discussing the plot, including the ending.
Spoilers be ahead. So let's start with Karen Page.
Poor Karen.
I know. As soon as you get into this story, she's on smack.
She's on smack. Porn star on smack.
I was like, my mind was already blown, man. I was like, holy crap. This isn't like the Spidey comics I was reading around that time.
They were
talking about porn and smack.
Yes, and she sells the name Matt Murdock for a fix.
Blew my mind. Yeah. All right. She was supposed to be their loyal secretary, Matt Murdock's girlfriend.
Yeah. Matt Murdock, and sells him out.
Sold him out to the kingpin.
Well, she didn't know to the kingpin. Sold him out to her pimp, I assume, or producer.
Yeah. To the producer of her movies.
And he eventually sold it all along to the kingpin.
Right, right. So, Daredevil initially investigates, who is it, Manolis? Manolis?
Manolis.
Manolis, the what is it? The detective. He was trying to frame Murdock in exchange for medical treatments for his son.
Yeah, he was being forced to do it. Basically, he was set up, and he didn't know by whom. And you have this great scene and a great panel, just one panel where Daredevil has wiped out an entire bar.
Yes.
And he's screaming, "Who's gonna talk about Matt Murdock?" This was it. The Kingpin was setting him up. It was like a plan. First, get his license pulled.
Right.
Then get his house blown up.
Blew up his apartment, and it was nice, too. He had a nice little spot.
So now he's homeless. He has no job. But as he says, with the explosion of his apartment, the signature on who did it, it was the Kingpin.
And at the same time, he's doing little things like, oh, shutting off his power. Oh, yeah. Shit. I just got this in the mail. My accounts are frozen. Yeah. Oh, no.
It was a great frame up. It was a complete destruction of Daredevil. And I think the apex was when the two men were mugging the charity Santa Claus guy, the guy who rings the bell.
Oh, yes.
When they were pulling off his suit, Daredevil tried to stop it.
Matt Murdock tries to stop it,
gets stabbed in the stomach, and fails to do so. He has completely been destroyed.
On his
Daredevil way, no longer exists.
On his way across the street, he got hit by a car.
Yeah, he got hit by a car.
Holy shit.
And you see him falling asleep. With his, remember when he had his lower back exposed in the snow?
Yeah.
He's all curled up into a ball in his chair. It's like, oh man, I know that.
That artwork was so gritty and dark. I thought Frank Miller did the artwork, but it was Mazzucchelli who did the art.
Yes.
And my mind was blown. Every panel just really had you craving for the next one. I was so loving the story as a whole. Artwork went with it so well.
And next, fast forward to Daredevil Born Again. He's dragged into a church.
Yes.
Cared for by a nun who turns out to be
Matt Murdock's mom.
His own mother.
His own mother.
His life.
That was mind blowing because he asked the question.
Are you my mom?
Are you my
heart? It's of course not my child.
Yeah.
Her heart skipped a beat, saying that she was lying.
Exactly. So he knew It was his mom.
And he just laid there grinning.
He did.
But then some maniac got a hold of the Daredevil costume, remember?
I do remember that. But before we get to that, I want to stay in that church for a minute because there's a lot of Christian imagery.
Well, it's called Born Again. You can't get away from it. He's Catholic. There's a lot of Catholic, what do you call
iconography.
It? Iconography.
Yeah.
And it's there. It didn't bother me.
It didn't bother me at all.
I thought it was well done.
They had...
the Pieta
laying down, yeah exactly.
The Pieta, she's right. Holding him, and then you know,
yeah, that was.
And then he had him laying there, and he had the. it was odd. I thought at the time, odd definitely. Choice, but it worked.
It worked. It worked for me. Fine. Yeah. It's born again. He's resurrected. He's Jesus Christ.
That's right.
Possibly
it's him and Darth Vader.
But fast forward to the. What do you call a guy who's not a seamstress but is a tailor?
Tailor
making a costume.
Yes,
and this costume is going on the aforementioned maniac.
There's no other way to describe him. Just a serial killer on the loose.
Yeah, I love how who do they have call up? It was Kingpin. Kingpin called in a favor, basically. Mm-hmm. Called in a favor with a general, and he's like, hey, is he available? Because I need him out here. I was like, who's he? Oh, no.
Well, and then moving along, he faces the Daredevil killer, takes him down, retrieves his suit.
Yes.
And at this time, we kind of sidestepped to Ben Urich's story, another fantastic side story in there.
Yeah.
But Ben Urich's preparing a story on the corruption in the Kingpin and his connection to this general, and he gets a phone call. And you just see him on the phone with this horrified look on his face.
Yeah, and I mean, that artwork was so good. I felt bad for Ben Urich.
Everything was tense around him. The copy had to go out.
Right.
His editor is standing over him, yelling at him, and finally pulls a page out of his typewriter and walks off, and Ben's still there on the phone.
Still on the phone, like, oh,
and,
shit.
And just to drive the point home, they break his wrist or his hand or something. He has a cast. And then 2 weeks after the cast was supposed to come off, he's still wearing the cast.
He's still wearing it, yeah.
Still scared to go to work.
But he does have his redemption.
Yes, he does.
Well, which I really love. The nurse that
she was
put
frightening.
In work, she was very frightening.
She was scary.
Nurse Ratched,
yes.
Not as frightening as this lady. That was nuts. Nurse Lois.
Lois, she was scary. Yeah. I love when she was arrested and he's just, hi, Ben. And he goes, hi, Lois.
Nothing even happened.
It was crazy.
And I love how, you know, Daredevil and Spider-Man universes, I mean, it's the same Marvel universe, but they're in the same... damn city, but
yes.
You know, Ben Urich and Spider-Man stories, Robbie Robertson,
as
J. Jonah Jameson.
Well, you look at this, I always thought this was ridiculous. You have somebody going, destroying part of the city,
right?
And one superhero shows up. It's like everyone else has seen this on the news and says, someone else will get it.
Yeah,
didn't happen in Born Again.
Yeah,
Kingpin brings in Nuke. Nuke takes the red pill.
Nuke starts
blowing up New York, and who shows up? Daredevil shows up, but the Avengers showed up,
which was
they're
really
not
going to
stand by and watch the city be destroyed.
Exactly. And I thought that was an awesome thing
that, was excellent.
That they did, bringing in the Avengers. That was crazy.
So Daredevil, with help of the Avengers, they take down Nuke. Not technically, who was it? He got shot in the chest. By his own man, because they didn't want him to talk.
Right, exactly.
And Daredevil, in the big finale, brings him in and dumps
him
on
the
Ben
Urich.
Yes. No.
And you've got another somewhat stigmata-ish scene with Nuke laying on the desk, face tattooed like with the American
flag. Boys.
For our boys. Yeah. Yep, I would love that. So...
questions.
That's pretty much the story, and let's jump into our question portion. Let me start out. Does this story hold up, and do these themes in this story hold up from your young brain to now?
Absolutely. I think it held up in the 90s when all people wanted was boobs and violence. It gave you violence, but it gave you a good story. Holds up today because the art's solid, the story is gripping. And I think it's going to hold up for the next 100 years.
Yep, I'm inclined to agree.
Now, have you ever read any Frank Miller's Daredevil before Born Again?
No. This was my first time reading Frank Miller Daredevil. He's got other stories in the Daredevil.
Yeah, he was mentioned slightly for a few issues.
Okay.
These characters like, Bullseye and Elektra. Right. They're minor characters.
Well, who knew? I mean, well, you know what? I'm definitely going to be looking into reading more if you've got those for me to read.
Yeah.
When did you first read this story?
I read it when it came out. I was a big Daredevil fan.
I remember. And 1986.
I had not read Frank Miller's previous block of Daredevils. Mm-hmm. They were too expensive. And they were after the time I started collecting, which was mostly, I like to say, Daredevil and the Black Widow era.
Mm-hmm.
Is where I had started reading it. But I read it when it came out. It was gripping. I was just blown away. And I was really disappointed when they left and it went back to normal.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Isn't that a killer when you have this huge story and these guest artists and guest writers? And it's like, oh, crap. We're back to
I was ruining the day when McFarlane left.
Yeah. All right. As a Spider-Man fan, how did you like the treatment of the Kingpin in this story?
Oh, I loved it. In this, he was so, he was really lethal. He was evil. He was an awful human being. I mean,
and a better fighter than Daredevil.
And a better fighter surprised than Daredevil, me. Which I really did like.
That really surprised me. He got beat down.
Well, from earlier issues of Spider-Man, Spider-Man would take on the Kingpin, and the Kingpin would always give him a good fight. And Spidey can bench press 10 tons. I'm like, he should be beating the Kingpin's ass any day.
But Kingpin's a rough customer.
But he is a tough guy. He is tough. And I loved his treatment in the story. He was, like, ruthless, which I really liked seeing.
Mm.
Let's see. Do you think, did this arc do justice to Daredevil overall?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, Daredevil, I think, has always had a pretty good level of arc. Romita Jr., and he had Romita Sr. for a short time. And
yes.
He had Frank Miller drawing for a while. And it's like, I think they've always had solid artists, but David Mazzucchelli doesn't do a lot of work, and when he does, he knocks it out the park.
Oh, yeah. I would, if I was reading Daredevil back then, I'd be in love.
And this question's already answered by you. Would this motivate you to read more Frank Miller stories or Frank Miller Daredevil?
Definitely. I'm familiar with other Frank Miller stories, but I definitely want to read some more Frank Miller Daredevil jams. Please. I would love to. All right. And last but not least, how would you grade this? What letter grade would you give this story?
Oh, wow. Daredevil Born Again would definitely get a solid A.
All right. Well, you heard it here first.
Well, how would you grade it?
I would grade A. Definitely A.
Not an A plus?
Yeah, I'll give it an A.
See, I'll give it an A. We agree today. We give Daredevil Born Again a solid A.
Yes, solid A. And, I mean, hey, that's it. To all our loyal listeners, if you have any trade paperbacks, story arcs, or graphic novels you would like us to discuss, please leave a comment down below. I've been Ralphie D.
And I'm JB.
So long for now, and keep reading and watching
Hella Trades.
I've done it. Pull yourself together.